Okay, so I'm just gonna zoom out to see the whole layer by hitting the globe, and then I'm gonna collapse these guys, collapse that layer there, and turn these guys off just so this loads a little bit. Everything's faster and clean. And the last step that we need to do is just kind of satisfy this idea that the parking lot shouldn't be within a quarter mile, and as you go more than a quarter mile, like it's better to have the lot be as far away as possible. So to do this, I'm going to use a tool that we've used before. What do you think it's going to be? We just used it today. Because what I want to do is change the values based on, right? So I'm going to reclassify. And so, but again, let's just add it to our model so that. What I'm going to do here, again, grab MJ, move over, and then grab reclassify. I'm going to grab it from spatial analyst, not 3D analyst, because you don't have probably the permission to use it. And then I'm going to use the magic to do this, to my last trick for today, and I'm going to double click on reclassify. And then to start with, I'm going to say, well, what I really want to do, and I have a plan for this, and my plan is to have five classes. And so to do that, I'm going to go into here and say, look, I want to designate five classes and say, okay. And what I'd like to do is say that everything from that is zero, I'd like to go to no data. And now everything from zero to well, we got to do a quarter mile, and so that question of like what's the units here is now very important. And so, how'd you guys figure out, or did you just wait? Here's how you figure it out. Go to source. So you right click on this guy, you go to source. This is telling you the extent, so number of columns and rows. This is telling you the cell size. It's telling you how big it is. Telling you what kind of pixel that it's. This is not an integer. It's a floating point. So on, and then eventually you're going to get to something that says spatial reference linear unit. Okay, so the units are going to be based on the linear unit of the reference system, and in this case, the reference system is this thing called state plane that we're going to talk about, and the unit of this reference system is meter. So our distances are being measured in unit, but our instructions have asked us to kind of think about a quarter mile as a cutoff. So what I usually do when I have to go between two unit conversions, I just go to Google and say quarter mile in meters. And look, I must have asked it this recently. So 0.25 miles is 402.36. And you can even highlight that and copy it. And so now when you go over to, let's see, to this guy, and you look at your reclassification scheme, and you say that 0 is going to go, and I want that to go to no data. Oh, and then I'm sorry. Meh, well, that was not a happy sound. Okay, so I'm going to go to classify. And wow, it really. Okay, so if this happens, you can always say cancel and then try again. Say, sorry for the wonk there, reclassify. But what I'd like to do is get five classes and say, okay. And I want this one to go to no data. And I want this one to go from 0 to a quarter mile. And I want that to be 0. And then I want, right? So I'm saying everything that had been 0 that represents our background, I'd like it to kind of disappear. And then everything that doesn't meet our criteria, I'm going to say are 0 because it's false. Like we shouldn't consider those guys. And then what I'm going to do is just go from, let's see, 402.36, 336. To, and I'd like to go to a half mile. So, what if I made this half mile. Now I've got this number, and if I go back over to here, I can stick that in, right? And then I think that's good. There's still space there. And then I can go over to here, highlight that, delete it, stick that in, and then this, I'd like to go up to 3/4 mile. So if I type in 0.75, that gets me to here. And then once again, I can highlight that, go over to here, and 805 to this is good. And then here, I can re-put that in. So now I'm going from that number to this number, and that presumably is the maximum number in my data set, but if I wanted to be absolutely sure, I could just kind of type in a bunch of nines here, just because certainly there's nothing in my our data set that's greater than that. And then rather than say 0, 3, 4, 5 in business, I'm gonna say that's gonna be 10, that's gonna be 20, and that's going to be 30, and I'm just trying to get enough range in values here that I don't know if this matters. Like 1, 2, 3 might work, but I'm trying to get enough range in our values here to be able to get a kind of enough contrast in our display ramp that we're going to be putting on this thing eventually at the very, very end. And then now I need to tell it where to stick it, right? And so since it's the last step, I'm just going to say 06, and this is the kind of the results. So these are parking lots, and I'm going to say that they're actually kind of scored, or parking lots scored as suitability. And you don't have to write exactly what I'm saying, but this is giving us a feeling for the higher the number, the more suitable these places would be for freshman parking, or for sheer parking, excuse me, it's late. And, or it's not late, but it's, I'm ready to be done with this, and I'm sure you are too. And so, same drill. Have that highlighted, right click, and say run. And that's red, but things are good. You're concerned about red here, not red here. Say close, I'm gonna save this guy, and then I'm gonna close it. And I'm going to go over to here, and I'm going to grab from the catalog, close the identity, grab this parking lots that are scored, and lo and behold, we have this, which is a map showing us that these places that are hot are probably your best places. The black are no good. The green, and this is maybe a little bit confusing, and actually I don't like that, really. So what you could do is go in here and say, let's just keep it simple and do our heat metaphor, which I had just seen. And I'm gonna click on this to say flip the colors. And now blue means kind of no good, and red means good. And so what you'll see is, I think what they settled on are, is it these spaces, or do you push them all the way up to, no, it's actually, I can't remember even where freshmen have to park, first years have to park. I think that's one of the lots though, isn't it? And isn't there a lot in here? Or did they push them all the way up to here, which would be interesting. I think they used to be actually around the athletic center, but with the new change, it's changed. Anyway, so there it is. There's our final results. I'm going to hit save and make sure that this map is saved, because that might be nice to have. And then the main thing is that we now have this model. So let's say that I did something as, let's see, before I do it, let's open this up and let's go here and say model delete intermediate data. And what you should now see is that if you go here, you've now erased, like 01 is we didn't use in our model, 02 was just by the first time we did this, and 03 was the first time we did this without using the model. But I think we can even go in and delete these guys. And I think we can even go so far as deleting our answer, but you may not want to do this until I tell you may not want to do any of this until I prove you that this is indeed the way it works. And so now if I hit save and I go to model and say delete intermediate, I just did that. And now I believe as long as I'm able to overwrite a file, and let me show you how to give yourself permission to do that. If you go to geoprocessing options, you can say overwrite the outputs and make sure that that's checked. So that's going to allow you to write over a file even if it has the same name. Notice that I still have this unchecked because I tend to work. We'll talk about that. So if I bring this guy back up and if I say now run the entire model, it's going to click through and go through all of these steps again. And so what I'm trying to do is show you that you can get rid of a lot of your intermediate files when you're using Model Builder, because you can always recreate them. You just want to make sure you don't get rid of your inputs, and that's why they're kind of blue, because they're kind of, you know, they're pretty valuable. But all the rest of these guys you can kick out relatively quickly just because you have the model saved. And so, right, you now have all of these files that you've recreated, including the very final one. All right, so that's just, I'd like you to kind of be able to get in the habit, just so that we don't take up a lot of space, that when you do use Model Builder, if the model works and you're done with it, your very last step should be to delete the intermediate data, and that's going to help us use less space on the server as the class progresses. Fair enough. So I think what I'm going to do then is just make sure that this guy is still on here as my final ta-da. Save the map, and see you in lecture.